Hi, I'm Max Dalton, and in this video, I'm going to talk through how to mark up screenshots on an Apple iPhone or iPad. With the rollout of iOS 11, Apple made it easy to quickly mark up and edit screenshots captured on an iPhone or iPad. This is great for working with images you'll want to use to build out a tutorial for work, to help friends or family work through a problem they're having with their device, and much, much more. This video walks you through all aspects of the editing tools available for marking up screenshots. Step 1. Press the power and home buttons at the same time on your Apple iPhone or iPad to capture a screenshot of your device's screen. The screen will flash, indicating you've successfully taken the screenshot, and a small image of that screenshot appears for roughly 3 seconds in the lower left corner of your device's screen. Step 2. Tap the image of the screenshot that appears in the lower left corner of your device's screen to bring up a markup window with the screenshot you just captured in the center of it. Step 3. Hold your finger against the blue handles that appear at the corners or in the center of the sides, and then move your finger to bring the outer edge inward and back outward. Repeat this process with other handles to crop your image around a specific location, and then double tap inside of the lit part of the image to crop it. Step 4. Make note of the drawing tools that are located along the bottom of the screen. The items that appear in the list from left to right are pen tool, marker tool, pencil tool, eraser tool, lasso tool, and color selector. Step 5. Tap either the pen tool, marker tool, or pencil tool to select your drawing device. After selecting your drawing device, the drawing device you selected will raise up slightly to be higher than the other drawing tools. Step 6. Tap the color selector icon. A palette of colors you can choose from appears. Tap the color you want the drawing tool you selected to apply to your image when you mark it up. After selecting a color, the tip of your drawing tool will change to reflect the color you selected. Step 7. Tap your chosen drawing tool to close the color palette. Step 8. Use your finger to draw on your screenshot. You can change the color you're using at any time. Additionally, if you make a mistake, you can tap the undo icon that appears in the upper right corner of the screen. The undo icon features a curvy left-pointing arrow. Alternatively, there's a redo button to the right of the undo button you can use as well. Step 9. Tap the eraser tool if there are specific parts of your drawing that you want to remove. The eraser tool will now be elevated above the other drawing tools to indicate that it's selected. Step 10. Tap the specific elements of your drawing you apply to your screenshot that you want to remove, and those elements will disappear immediately after you touch them while the eraser tool is selected. Step 11. Tap the lasso tool if there are any items you've drawn on the screen that you want to move without affecting the screenshot. Step 12. Draw a circle around the drawing elements you want to move to select them. Press your finger against any space inside of the circle you drew, and then move your finger around the screen to move those specific drawing elements. Remove your finger from the screen after moving the drawing elements to the location where you want them to be located. Alternatively, briefly tap the inside of the lasso circle to bring up a context menu, and then tap Delete to get rid of the selected drawing elements. Step 13. Tap the Edit icon in the lower right corner of the screen. The edit icon features a plus symbol. A context menu appears with other display options. Step 14. Choose Text within the edit menu to place a text box on the screen. Tap the text box once to select it, and then hold your finger against it to move it around the screen to the location where you want it. Double tap inside of the text box to display an on-screen keyboard you can use to input text. Step 15. Choose Signature within the Edit menu. A new signature window appears. Use your finger to sign your signature on the line at the bottom of the screen. Tap Done when you're happy with your signature. The signature you added will appear inside of an image box on the screen that can be moved to a specific location on the screen. Additionally, whenever you choose to add a signature again, you'll be able to select the signature you just added to use it, or you can add a new one. Step 16. Choose Magnifier within the Edit menu. A circle that acts as a magnifying glass appears on the screen. Everything inside of the circle will be magnified. Hold your finger against the inner part of the circle and then move your finger to change the location of the magnifying glass. Additionally, you can change the size of the circle by holding your finger against the blue dot on the outer part of the circle and then moving it inward and outward. Finally, you can change the zoom level within the circle by sliding the green dot on the outer edge of the circle to the left and right. Step 17. Choose any of the shape icons along the bottom of the edit menu to place those shapes on the screen. All shapes can be resized, and the color of the shapes can be changed as well using the color selector. Step 18. Tap the export icon in the lower left corner of the screen to save or share the screen you just edited. Step 19. Tap Done in the upper left corner of the screen when you're finished. You'll be presented with options to save your marked up screenshot to the Photos app or delete it.